Regulation is the government making sure that the market stays honest. It functions as the policeman or the referee on the field. There's always an controversy as to how much regulation is needed. Bureaucrats love to regulate, that's their job. And so they find out new ways to do it. Sometimes they're unnecessary. The Forest Service, for instance, recently issued an advisory on how to make s'mores.
As John said, it's about the referee on the field. It's setting the rules. There's a lot of products where we would count on the government to give us, you know, certain guarantees because we can't count on the companies to do it. Where you could have a problem of over-regulating is we don't want the government restricting choice, imposing cost without any good public purpose.
Regulators are human. They follow their self-interest, same as everybody else. And this can have very pernicious effects, especially in the long term. For instance, railroads in the 19th century, they began with the ICC, the Interstate Commerce Commission, which promptly got captured by the industry. Regulatory capture is when the government sets up a regulatory apparatus to police a particular market. And they need expertise. Well, who has expertise in the railroad industry? The railroad industry. So they begin to go to work for the regulatory body, and pretty soon they're running the show. And so the industry captures the regulatory body.
The problem of regulatory capture is a very real one. So, you know, if you look at, for example, the Securities and Exchange Commission, let's say that they know that Goldman Sachs is doing something improper. What's their ability, what's their incentive of the individual regulator to crack down? You know, on top of that, you have many people at, you know, the Securities and Exchange Commission who probably would like nothing more than to be able to work at Goldman Sachs. So you do have a very real issue of regulatory capture, which is why, you know, in my view, you have to be careful where you regulate, how you regulate, and, you know, again, what those incentives look like to the regulators, because you can get a situation where we think the Securities and Exchange Commission is policing, you know, the financial sector, when in fact they're doing the opposite.